Hi, welcome back to our blog. I'm Tim Heil, and today I want to talk with you about Obama's new healthcare bill that's been passed recently and how it has an effect on real estate taxes for personal residents. Now, before we get to the healthcare bill, it's important to know a little bit of background knowledge on how people are taxed, how homeowners are taxed in the state of Texas on their personal residence. So basically, when you sell a home, the rule is if you've lived in it 2 out of the last 5 years, then you don't pay any taxes on the profit from the home unless you receive profit higher than $250,000, and for a married couple, higher than $500,000. So I've drawn a quick example up here to illustrate how that works. If you buy the home for $300,000 and you sell for $400,000, whether you're single or a couple, you don't pay any taxes. If you sell for $500,000, you don't pay any taxes. If you're a couple, If you sell for $800, you still don't pay any taxes. You only pay taxes when you sell for over $500,000 more than what you bought it for, showing a profit of over $500,000. So if you sold for $900, you made a $600,000 profit, you'll pay capital gains taxes on $100,000. And for a single person, that starts at the $250,000 mark, where you start paying capital gains taxes on the profit that you receive from the sale of your home. Now, this is only if you've lived in the home personally 2 out of the last 5 years, and this is your personal residence. With that background knowledge, let's dive right into the bill and how it works. The bill, we've been getting a lot of emails, a lot of questions, a lot of forwards being sent to us with frustrations with this new bill that's been passed, especially how it relates to real estate, because there's a 3.8% tax on additional tax on your personal residence. So a lot of rumors have been spreading around that, you know, if you sell a $300,000 home, you could have $10,000, $12,000 in taxes. And we want to clear that. We want to clear the air on this. That's not the case. The tax is not on your entire sales price. So if you sell the home for $900,000, you are not paying $27,000 in real estate taxes. That's just not how it works. The rule in the state of Texas, where you are protected for $250,000 of profit or $500,000 as a married couple, still remains the same. So you will still pay no taxes within that range. However, for people who sell and make a higher profit than that, that are paying capital gains taxes on the profit over the $250,000 or the $500,000 mark, those people will pay an additional 3.8% tax. Now, this 3.8% tax, here's how it works. In this scenario, if you buy for $300,000, you live in the home 2 out of the last 5 years, and then you sell it for $900,000, then your exemption amount as a married couple would be $500,000 or $250,000 as a single person. And so your capital gain that you're taxed on would be $100,000 as a married couple, or in this scenario, $350,000 as a single person. So the healthcare tax, 3.8%, is an additional tax on top of your capital gain tax of these amounts. So I want to be very clear that, you know, if you make a $600,000 profit here, the additional tax is $3,800, not $27,000 or $30,000. However, it's still important to know about this tax because this could affect each and every one of you. Now, another important thing to know is that this tax is only imposed on individuals who make over $200,000 a year, or couples who have a combined income of over $250,000 a year. So if you have a combined income of less than $250,000, or if you're a single person with less than $200,000, then none of this applies to you, and you still remain paying your normal capital gains taxes on anything over the $250,000 or the $500,000 mark. So I just wanted to clear the air, make sure everybody understands the healthcare 3.8% tax on personal residence. If you have any questions at all, feel free to give me a call at 512-689-4835. Or you can call our office at 330-1047, or you can shoot me an email. We'd be happy to answer questions how it relates to you specifically, and we'd love to hear from you. Thank you so much for watching.